Moscatos are lower in alcohol. Yeah. And so if you're looking for something that has a little sweetness plus a little more alcohol, I'd recommend our Zinfandel Rosé. This does have more alcohol than this. This is actually 10.7% versus only 5.5. Oh, taste it, see how you like it.
Down the hatchet.
Think that'll be good? Based on what you're telling me about what you like, and
it's one,
and that it's got more alcohol.
Okay, cool. Right, I'm gonna put this in my engine. Start my engine. Or maybe I could paint a picture of this. Paint a picture?
Sure you can. What can I get you? A health food drink here. This is our acai raspberry. Now that acai is a berry that's supposed to have all these antioxidants. It's good for you. You're into antioxidants, aren't you? We'll get you some acai berry.
That's the antioxidant?
Yeah, because it's got the acai berry in it. Yeah. So this is our Pearlicious. It's actually a white wine blend with the addition of pear juice and natural flavors.
Hello, and welcome to the Empowering Group Art Therapy Workshop. And what we have planned here for you this evening is an opportunity for you all to rediscover yourselves. All right? And this is going to happen by means of imagery and making your thoughts and your feelings tangible by placing them on a paper in order to form a collage. So she was absolutely correct. Now, my name is Talona Shalay, for those of you who do not know. I am an artist. I've painted for the President of the United States, the proud and loving family of Trayvon Martin, for our Tuskegee Airmen, Dr. Ruth, and for many others. But what I want to do is share the story of a very special individual by the name of Rags. Nice shoes. Now, what also makes Rags special is that she is purely fictional. Okay? But her story goes like this. The year cannot be recalled, nor the reason why be recited. But one special day, a beautiful, beautiful child was born onto the rich green earth. I just want you to listen. One day, the young girl's parents were in a fatal accident that left the girl without family and without anyone to care for her. And as a result, the young girl had to then take care of herself. At this point, she was forced to prepare her own meals and find her own food, which consisted of figs, nuts, and berries. She had to scrub her own soiled clothing and find her own shelter each and every night. The fact of the matter is that nobody, absolutely nobody, wished to take care of her. She, unto which her true name is unknown, was not favored by others. She was dirty. Sometimes she couldn't find enough water to bathe herself with. She was small. Her malnutrition body wouldn't grow properly. And she even spoke funny. Nobody cared to be seen standing next to her long enough to help her correctly pronunciate her native tongue. And so without favor, she inherited the difficult task of teaching herself how to read and write. Now, she, until which her true name was unknown, had a plan, though. She wished to travel across the earth. She wanted to reach its end. She didn't care to be around so many people who didn't care for her. And so that's what she did. She packed up all of her belongings and she set out through town in order to make her way. And as she did so, the people of the town, they laughed at her. They pointed fingers. "Look," they said, "she, unto which her true name is unknown, walks through town in the daylight hours. How dare she," they said. "We can see her." But she, unto which her true name was unknown, was much too determined. So she ignored these ignorant comments and proceeded to march on. Days and days and lifetimes and lifetimes her journey lasted, when finally she approached a huge cliff. "Look," said the young girl, now a young lady, "the end of the earth." She, unto which her true name is unknown, quickly rushes to the edge. She had much to ponder. And as she did so, a single weakened cry of "Help!" ascended from down below. Surely the young woman was a bit delusional. I mean, after all, she just traveled across the earth with a single piece of fruit. And so she, unto which her true name is unknown, proceeds to the edge. But the cry of "Help!" comes again. "Help!" from down below. Immediately, she, unto which her true name is unknown, she submits and drops to her knees in order to locate the origin of the distraught prayers. But nothing could be located, and nothing could be observed. "Help!" But the pleas kept coming. And so she, unto which her true name is unknown, starts taking off her rags and ties them together in order to create a rope. There's just something down there. But she doesn't know what it is, but she has to make those cries materialize. So she starts tying the rags into ropes. And she lowers it, starts fishing, hoping that whatever is down there grabs on. But nothing reacted. And so she keeps trying, when suddenly she feels a tug. And it's so powerful that it pries the rope out of her hand, and she tries to hold on, but she's small and she's frail. And she knows she needs more might in order to bring the cries of help to safety, in order to make them materialize. But how? She just didn't know how. She was small. She didn't understand how she needed to help this individual. She starts to talk to herself, "Please, I need help." And suddenly, a voice from within begins to respond to the little girl, now a young woman. "You can do it," says the young woman. And with this, and with those empowering words, they begin to root themselves. And this gave her that extra power that she needed. She let go all of the foul thoughts and inappropriate comments, and it made way. It gave her the extra strength And she was able to pick that up and bring that life to safety off of empowering words. And because she believed in herself. And well, that's the story of Rags. And that's what we're going to do here today. I want you to create your own story. And it's going to be your own goals. And it's going to be inspired by Rags. And it's going to be a 5-year plan. And it's going to start from this day forward. Do you understand me? Do you understand what I'm saying? We are going to make sure that your thoughts and your ideas and your inspiration is tangible, that you can touch it. And this is a map of sorts, and it's going to be used every day if it needs to be. Do you understand? There's power in words, and you're going to create yours right now. There's power in imagery, and you're going to create yours right now. Okay? So I've placed materials in front of you. I've placed some of my inspirational artwork. Whatever it is that you're needing, painting, images, whatever it is that you need, all right? And I want you to take the rest of the time to create your reality. However you want to see yourself in 5 years, you're going to put it on this paper. Do you understand what I'm saying? All right. Does anyone have any questions? With that being said, let's begin.
Thank you.
What's happening?
Well, you know, Mr. Mike, I just want to know how you are feeling about this event. How are things going with you?
So far, so good.
Yeah.
It's coming on, too. Check that out.
Oh, nice.
This is my inspiration. Well, not these right here, but for the next 5 years. I don't know if you can zoom in that far, but it's my project for the next 5 years.
It's all
seeds, the strings, and the, well, the knitting, and then inspiration up here, but I have to add some extra stuff on there. But yeah, so far, so good.
Okay. Serious doubts about herself, and she is on such a roll right now, so something got her going, something.
She's very shy.
So please share with us, I mean, what was it that got you going? What happened? What was it?
I was just thinking, this is something I've always wanted, so why not go for it? And it's a restaurant. I wanted like an international restaurant that I could be able to cater for different minority, different race. Something like more like a
this is about everybody.
French cuisine, but with different menu, different stuff on there.
She just got here. She just got here.
Talk about your project.
Oh my God, you are too early. You are way too early.
Oh, too early.
No, well, this is a steak.
Did she tell you that?
Menu. Also, I want it to look more like this, the outside of the restaurant.
This is funny.
I wanted flowers during the day and at night more of a darker setting, like a French cuisine, Caribbean style, all mixed up in one. I want somewhere where everybody will be feeling comfortable at home, I'm outgoing. I think it suits my personality as well. And also, I'm a very good cook, and I've always wanted my own restaurant. Save for it, I'm just scared of having it because I don't want to lose all my money, which everyone told me that I wouldn't be losing.
There's no reason for them to do that.
I like black and I also like red, so of course the deco will be black and red. That's it for now.
Thanks, Nikki. The concept behind my artwork is this is about growth. The tree represents growth. And in order to grow, you have to have roots, and it's rooted in the soul. And if you look upward towards the tree, this is about taking paths and taking chances in life and expecting to learn and expecting that there will be bumps, but in the end, they'll be awesome bumps. Living with passion, going big, centering around family and believing, exploring, respecting. So this represents my journey that I expect over the next 5 years.
It's Kim, and I can't hold it up because it's not glued on yet. But mine was inspired from my friend who is in intensive care right now, and it's about just living for today. So it's about being healthy, living, loving, and laugh. Be your best at all time. You don't have to compromise. Smile, and good things will always come to you.
What's your name?
Ruth Jackson. I'm painting, reaching for the sun and the stars.
Freedom, free-flowing essence of life.
My name is Shimon Campos, and this represents where I am and where I'm going. I am going on the second year of breast cancer survival, so I am mastering my time and the breast cancer survivor journey. And my priorities are with my family. I am the queen of my household. I am the answer lady, and hopefully the things that I pursue in life will change the world in some way.
What's your name?
Christine. I'm a friend of Shalay's. Yes. 20 years. Mine is just personal journey. God as the center, wisdom, fireworks, femininity, fragrance, vacations, love. And I'm still envisioning my 5-year plan. I'm not artistic, so I'm just putting images on paper to symbolize what I want the next 5 years.
Chai Jackson, CEO of X Factor Group. This here is, I'm actually reaching out to the Latin market, so the Latino woman. This is Zoe, and she had a hard time getting a lot of parts because she's like brown skin. But Zoe, I saw her in center stage as a ballet dancer, and she was absolutely fabulous. So the new show, we have a show now called Out and About, but my new show is going to feature a black Latin woman, and it's going to, whatever your skin story, be beautiful. In other words, regardless of what color you are, remember to be beautiful first.
My name is Talona Shalay, and I want to thank you for joining me this evening. This event was far greater than I ever anticipated, and I look forward to working with you next.